Loosen the blue thumb screw on the riser retention jacket and set the retention jacket aside. Turn the riser onto its side. Hold the riser steady, then unlock the blue retention clip and rotate it to the open position. Grasp the accelerator card only by its post and cutout. Carefully remove the card, pulling it out of the PCIe slot connector in the direction of the arrows. You will be installing the new accelerator card in PCIe slot 2, which is the center slot. Insert the bracket tab into the retaining slot in the riser. Push the card in the direction shown here until its connector is fully inserted into the PCIe socket. To confirm that the new card is seated correctly, ensure that the bracket tab is firmly seated in the retaining slot and that the PCI card is firmly seated in the PCIe socket. When correctly installed, the card connector is fully inserted into the PCIe socket so that none of the gold connection strips are visible. If you can see any of the connection strips, remove the card and reinsert it. Lift the back of the riser and ensure that the filler plates and accelerator card are correctly seated on the riser. With the card securely in position, close the blue plastic retention clip. Turn the riser and lay it flat. There are two slots in the bottom edge of the riser frame. Lift the front of the riser slightly to make sure that the lugs on the edge of the retention jacket engage with these corresponding slots in the riser frame. Make sure that these lugs remain in the slots when you rotate the retention jacket into position. On the inside of the retention jacket are two additional slots that are designed to secure the edges of the accelerator card when the jacket is closed. As you rotate the retention jacket into position, be sure to align the edges of the accelerator card with these two alignment slots on the retention jacket. It may be necessary to adjust the accelerator card for proper alignment. On either side of the blue thumb screw are two pointed lugs that must also fit into the corresponding slots in the riser frame. Make sure that these lugs fully engage with the slots before tightening the thumb screw. After checking to make sure that there are no obstructions in the riser slot, turn the riser over and lower it into position. Keep the riser level. Make sure that the riser aligns with the tracks in the rear of the enclosure. And also be sure that the black sleeve at the front corner of the riser slips over the steel post inside the riser slot. Press the riser down firmly until its connector is fully seated in the motherboard socket.